Hi, Alan Irwin, Santa Barbara Infrared, and in this video we're gathered together to talk about uniformity. So what does uniformity measure? Well, uniformity verifies that every sensor element in a focal plane array or some bigger sensor produces the same result when given the same stimulation. Sounds very simple, and basically conceptually it is very simple, but there are a lot of ambiguities that need to be specified to properly do this test, and that's where the trick is when we talk about uniformity. So the first ambiguity is whether or not we're talking about the offset uniformity or the response uniformity. The offset uniformity, what we're going to do is take a single image of a uniform source, and we're going to look at the variance on how all of those sensors respond within a single image. We could correct that by applying different offsets to every pixel so they all come out to be the same, but the initial reading, we are looking at that variation in the offsets. So there's our offset uniformity. The other type is where we're looking at the response of a pixel, and we're going to take every pixel and put it at two different temperatures and measure the response. And we're going to compare them all, and ideally they're all the same, but typically they're not. So we're looking at that variation, that non-uniformity in responses in the measurement. The next ambiguity is the formula that's being used. Now, to look at variation, as I mentioned, the standard way to approach that is with a standard deviation calculation. So we would take all the values, run a standard deviation, and get our variance, or standard deviation, value, and we compare that to something. One thing we can compare it to is the average of all the readings. So we take the standard deviation, we divide it by the average of the readings, we multiply that by 100%, and we get our uniformity value as a percentage. On the other hand, we could take that standard deviation and compare it to the maximum value in the scene, and then that would provide a uniformity measurement. There are other ways we could set that denominator, but of course you're going to get different values depending on what you're comparing it to, and that's an important part of our uniformity calculation. To add more complexity, the Night Vision Electronic Systems Directorate, NVESD, has a different way of calculating this. They refer to it as the blur uniformity, and that's a more complex formula that you see here, and is also assuming that you've run a blur convolution on the image, which we'll talk about a little later. So the formula being used for uniformity isn't standardized. We all have different ways of doing that. And there are different reasons why you would choose the average versus the maximum value. So that's part of the justification in the lab and how that uniformity is being calculated. The third is actually the term itself. Are we talking about uniformity or non-uniformity? We use uniformity as sort of the overall catch-all, but if you think about it, we have the standard deviation, which is measuring our variance. And if we had a perfectly uniform image, that standard deviation would be zero. So is our uniformity zero? Just as a term, it seems wrong. You refer to a uniformity, you want 100% uniformity, or you want a zero uniformity, meaning it's not uniform. So we use the term non-uniformity when we refer to that standard deviation divided by the mean or whatever, because when we get to zero, zero standard deviation means there's no non-uniformity. And uniformity is 100% minus the non-uniformity. But that's when you're being very precise. It's not always referred to that way. And so you need to be clear when we're referring to uniformity, which of those terms you're really referring to. So three different levels of ambiguity just to start off with. So how do we run this test? Well, we need to provide a uniform calibrated source, and that's typically an extended area blackbody. We can present that to the camera in a flood form, meaning we bring that body right up against the camera, or we can project it through a scene projection system into a portion of the image that we can well characterize. What we're going to do is take one or perhaps multiple images that we're then going to average if we are doing an offset uniformity. And if we're doing a response uniformity, then we're going to do that at two different temperatures and take our measurements across that. But we've got a range of pixels that we're interested in. We're going to take one of those two characteristics measurements, and then we're going to calculate standard deviation. If we're running the NVESD calculation, we also need to run a blur convolution. Now, what that means is that we're going to run a formula across this entire image. At every pixel, we're going to take its value and the value of its neighbors, determine an average or calculate the average of those values and replace the pixel value, the one we're looking at, with that average set. The size of the area, the neighborhood that we're going to use for our averaging can vary, so you need to specify that. And the result when this is done is a blurred image. For instance, in this image that you see here, the center section has been blurred. We've left the outer section unblurred, so you can see the difference between the two. But you're going to run this blur convolution, the size specified, again, by the testers, And then you're going to use the values from that blurred image, the maximum, minimum, and the rest, to put back into that NVESD formula to calculate out that uniformity. So how do we use this somewhat ambiguous test? Well, you use it to characterize a camera, and you can use it to calibrate a camera. I made some references to the fact that offsets, when we know them, we can apply an offset to make a correction. That's referred to as a one-point non-uniformity correction, or NUC. If you're going to correct the response of a camera, meaning you're going to look at the response of each pixel and apply a gain adjustment to each so that they all come out to have the same gain, then you're going to have to measure at two different points, and that's referred to as a two-point NUC. So you can use this calibration, this information in the uniformity measurement, to do your calibration. And you can, of course, use it to detect a failure. You have some cameras that are so non-uniform that they won't meet any particular task, and so you fail the camera. You can compare devices within a model run because you are seeing the quality of the two and whether or not you're getting good cameras coming out of it using the same formula. It becomes tricky, though, when you compare cameras from different model runs or different manufacturers, because at that point you need to identify how they perform their uniformity measurement. What are the specific values? You need to eliminate the ambiguities if you're going to compare those uniformities. And sometimes that's not always obvious. If it's always using the same calculation within a lab, then within a model run, that's a valid measurement. But when you're comparing across labs, they may be using different ways of calculating the value, and it's not so clear when you're doing that comparison. And that is how uniformity is applied.